Every 40 seconds, somewhere in the world, someone wants to end his or her life. In America, there are twice as many suicides as there are murders. Ben Courson knows all about these numbers because he was nearly one of them.
Ben Courson was only 18 when he began a 10-year struggle with depression, complex PTSD, and suicide.
I would go up to a skyscraper and I would walk on the railing. Another time I took up a knife to kill myself and God stayed my hand.
In time, Ben found freedom from that dark despair. As founder of Hope Generation, he encourages all who will hear that hope is not only possible, but within reach. In his latest book, Flirting with Darkness, Ben uncovers the major lies behind depression and offers 11 keys to defeating that darkness once and for all.
If God could heal me, and he has, I guarantee he can heal you.
Ben Courson is joining us now via Skype, and we welcome him back to the 700 Club. Hey, Ben, it's great to see you.
Thank you so much. Great to be with you guys again.
Ben, you were in a 10-year struggle with depression. I was just telling our producer, I'm shocked. You're like the happiest person I know, and we've had you on another show I do called Prayer Link numerous times, and I never knew this. What was happening to you during this time?
Well, a lot of people think I'm Tigger on steroids, and that just really shows that sometimes the image that we can project into the world, or this like avatar we hold up, sometimes is cognitive dissonance, and it doesn't always portray what's going on inside. So while a lot of people thought during my decade-long struggle with depression that I was very happy, I in fact felt like my future was swallowed by an infinite gray. And it wasn't just sort of a philosophical despair, it was basically environmental. In the sense that my brother went to heaven and my sister went to heaven. And after an 8-year relationship, I went through a really blindsiding heartbreak. And I felt like tomorrow would be no different than today. And after getting diagnosed with complex PTSD, I started to think that things would never get better.
How bad did it get?
Well, it got so bad that I didn't see any point in living anymore. You know, neurologists tell us that when you experience the emotion of hurt or the feelings of self-rejection, it's processed in your brain the same way your brain processes physical pain. Mm. So if you've ever been in so much physical pain that you're like, I will do anything to end the suffering, that's why depressed people are suicidal, because their brain neurologically is assimilating and computing that emotional hurt as physical pain, and that's how I felt.
Now, Ben, this struggle with depression coincided with you becoming a pastor. Did you ever feel that God was trying to tell you something and maybe ministry was not your calling?
Well, I know that the classic ministry, as I entered into it, it just wasn't me. Like, I like to skateboard. I like to be buoyant. I like to adventure with God and squad. I like to have fun. But I kind of felt like I had to be like this super serious, somber, sober saint. And I couldn't really live up to that. In fact, I was, I gave my first sermon in third grade, started preaching regularly at 16, traveling and teaching. And then at 18 years old, as a senior in high school, I became a pastor. And so I thought like I had to be way wiser than I really was to speak to people three times my age. And I think that sense that I had to like be something I wasn't made me really depressed.
Well, you wrote your book, Flirting with Darkness, as part of your healing process. Was there one single point where things started to turn around for you that you can pinpoint?
100%. One of the biggest things that God used to heal me from depression was my friends. You know, a lot of people think the way I'm going to get healed from depression is more ontological, existential navel gazing, or more deep coffee conversations, or like I'm going to have my veins bulging from my neck and I'm going to go on my knees and pray more. And while prayer and counseling and all these things were massive in getting me healed, another big thing was just my friends who grabbed skateboards with me, and they were crazy and hilarious, and they showed me that life could be fun again. Yeah. And that's what I'm trying to teach people, that life can be joyful. No matter what we go through, we can find hope.
Ben, you write about weapons to defeat the dark lord of depression. Walk us through some of those that you write about in your book.
One of them is prayer walks. You know, scientific research is showing us that when we talk to God about our hopes, fears, and dreams, it has the same effect on our brain as therapy. Wow. Wow. So that's what neurological research is showing us. When you talk to God about your hopes, fears, and dreams, it has the same effect on your brain as therapy. Another one is endorphins. Like, this is a real practical handle, but God put endorphins in your body so that when you exercise, you activate them. and they actually unleash these opioid receptors in your brain that act like morphine, the only natural chemical that's a painkiller in your brain. So that's why researchers tell us that if you go on a 40-minute jog, it has the same effect on your brain as a strong antidepressant. Another one is dreamality. That's a weapon I write about, how God can turn our reality into a dreamality. As we delight ourselves in the Lord, he gives us the desires of our heart. So we might have nightmares, but we also have dreams, and we will conquer our nightmares because of our dreams.
So your friends really helped you. Did you ever seek professional help? And at what point should a person seek professional help?
I did seek professional help. And the reason I knew I needed to is because I felt like a demon from the netherworld had lit my brain on fire and my consciousness was nothing but scorpion stings. And I felt like I was hopeless. I was in despair. And so when I went to my first therapist, it actually wasn't a good fit. He was a good guy. I tried another counselor a few years later, and this counselor used the talk cure. This counselor actually said, "Ben, you have one of the most difficult cases of depression I've ever had to treat. But after talking through my trauma, I found incredible healing." You know, there's this story in the Bible where Jesus cast out a demon after he asked what the demon's name was. He said, "What's your name?" And the demon said, "We are legion." And that's why there's such a thin line between demonic possession and oppression and mental illness in the Bible. And I think we have to name the demon in order for it to come out in a poetical sense. I think we have to name the anxiety, expose the shadows, drag it out into the light. And counseling is a big way to do that and thereby find healing. And that's true in my life, too.
Well, I love your ministry. It always brings a smile to my face. And we're still calling you Pastor. You're still Pastor Ben. So just in a different way, you can read more about other ways to defeat the dark lords of depression in Ben's book. Again, it's called Flirting with Darkness. It's available nationwide. You can also hear more with Pastor Courson by going to cbn.com. He is our featured speaker during our 7 days ablaze event. You don't want to miss it. You can stream that live on our website today at noon Eastern. Ben, thank you so much. You are truly a joy and a gift to the world. So I'm so glad you defeated depression and now you're helping the rest of us. God bless you.
I love you guys. God bless. We'll see you soon.
Amen.
Hey, Hope Generators, make sure to smash that like button below. You can hit subscribe so you make sure to be notified whenever we have new videos right up there. And then you can watch our next video so you can be empowered to be a hope dealer by clicking this box right here. I love you guys. And until next time, may the hope be with you.